Now let's review thin film interference. Let's say we have a soap bubble with N that equals to 1.34. On both sides of the soap bubble, we have air N equals to 1. And let's say the light that's shown on the soap film has a wavelength lambda. And we're looking this way. And the reason why we have thin film interference is because we have the light rays reflect off the first surface and then enters the second one and then gets reflected again. And these two reflected rays, they can interfere to give us the thin film interference. First, we have to look at the reflection to see if the peaks turn into troughs or not, or whether we have a half wavelength shift or not. This is N equals to 1, that's N equals to 1.34. When a light ray gets reflected off a bigger N, it is gets reflected off a slower medium, which is kind of like being reflected off a fixed end. So peaks turn into troughs, that means that we get half a wavelength shift. For this second reflection, it's reflected off N equals to 1 when the light goes from 1.34 to 1. It's reflected off of a smaller N, therefore peaks stay peaks. There is no half wavelength shift. However, this light ray has to travel this extra distance. If the thickness of the thin film is T, then this extra distance would be 2T. Now, it may look like it is more than 2T, but we're talking about really normal incidence. So the light ray is really going in perpendicular to the film and then bounces back perpendicular to the film. We're just drawing like this to exaggerate the situation so that we could see those two rays more easily. But these two rays, now let's look at the path difference. The path difference would be the difference of between the two. And I always use the 2t side minus the other side. So I get 0 plus 2t minus the other side. This is the path difference. How much this path difference equals to should depend on whether the interference is constructive or destructive. If it is constructive, what it means is that when you look into the soap film, you would see light being reflected. So if you shine a green light at the film, you would see green on the soap film. That's a constructive interference. If you see black, that means you do not see the green light being reflected. That means it is a destructive interference. So if we do not see reflection or we want to eliminate reflection, then it is a destructive interference. If we do see reflection, we see the color of light on the film, then it's a constructive interference. If it is constructive interference, the path difference should equal to 0 lambda, 2 lambda kind of number. If it's destructive interference, the path difference should be half wavelength numbers. Let's say we're looking for the minimum thickness. That means that we should start our path difference from the smallest number. So if it is a constructive interference, then we would have this 0 plus 2t minus half wavelength equals to 0. If this equals to 0, that means 2t would equal to lambda over 2. So the thickness would be lambda over 4. But this is the lambda in the thin film. When a wavelength is given in the problem, this is the wavelength in vacuum. So we'll have to turn this into the wavelength in the thin film. So that means the thickness would equal to the wavelength in vacuum divided by the N of the thin film. So in this case, we should divide the wavelength by 1.34 and then divide by 4 to get that minimum thickness. Now, if we do not see the reflection, if it is destructive interference, then we will say the path difference equals to half wavelength. So let's say this is 0 plus 2t minus half wavelength. If we set it equal to half a wavelength, then we would have 2t equals to 1 wavelength That means T is the wavelength divided by 2. Again, this is the wavelength inside the thin film, which means I'll have to do this again. I have to use the wavelength in vacuum divided by the N of the thin film, and then divided by 2. So it's this divided by 1.34 and then divided by 2 to get that minimum thickness. Occasionally, when we do this, we may end up having T equals to 0. The thin film cannot have 0 thickness. So that means this first number we tried does not work. Then we just have to go to the next number. If it's a constructive interference, then we use lambda instead of 0. And if it's destructive interference and the half lambda gives us T equals to 0, then we have to make the path difference equal to the next number. Now let's review polarization. Polarization only happens to transverse waves. We cannot polarize longitudinal waves like sound. Okay, so EM waves are transverse waves. So we can polarize EM waves like light. Let's say we start with an unpolarized light. That means we have electric field in all directions. The intensity of this unpolarized light is I0. And then we make it go through a polarizer. So when the light comes out, it is polarized. This polarized light only has half the intensity because half of the energy is in this direction. The other half of the energy is in the other direction that did not go through this polarizer. And then if we make this light go through a second polarizer that has an angle theta to the first one, then only the component of the electric field that's in this direction will go through, which is adjacent to the angle. So this component that goes through is E times cosine theta. And because the intensity is proportional to electric field squared, the electric field is like the amplitude. Intensity is proportional to the amplitude squared. So if the electric field changes by a factor of cosine theta, that means the intensity changes by a factor of cosine theta squared. So this is how the intensity changes.